Hey everybody, Varun here from Language Academy. Guys, once again, we are doing an online interview. Today, we have got Namik from Brisbane. Welcome, Namik. Congratulations. Namik has scored 8 each in his PT exam. And one thing which I would like to point out about him is that when he started his journey with us, he was sitting on 60, 62 in each and every module. Now, you've got 8 each in each and every module. Namik, how does that feel?
It feels amazing, sir. Like I was talking at 60, but I never think that I will be able to get 60 plus or 70 plus or 7 each or 8 each. But with the Language Academy, I got 8 each. That's awesome.
Thanks for that, Namik. Namik, so what I would like to point out over here, see, there are a few institutes in Brisbane as well, right?
Yes, sir.
Normally, students do prefer when it comes to PT preparation that, yes, we have to go to an institute because that gives us an extra push. But you opted for online classes. How are online classes important, and how did the online classes, feedback sessions, practice sessions help you to get to the score?
The online classes is important because if you want to get 8 each score, the feedback, the constructive feedback for each section and each question should be important. So I was talking at 60, but I was talking in speaking more about 60, 59. I started with the Language Academy and started with the online classes, and the feedback given by the Shaminder sir and you, that was a game changer for me.
Yeah, I remember you were around 59 in speaking, right? And this time you even got 9 in speaking. So, you know, that's a big difference from 60 to 90. That is a lot, and that basically requires you the right strategies and right feedback, because if you're getting 60 and then next time you get 90, it doesn't really mean that you're lacking somewhere. It's more about that you don't know what the computer is looking for. So if you know what the computer is looking for, if you answer each and everything carefully and properly, you are going to get the score. Narvik, listening was one section I remember you used to text me late at night as well. Why I'm not getting the score in listening, 73, 72, 74 every time. What do you think is important for listening?
Listening is like some written lectures, some spoken tests is important, but the most important is I have given number of mock tests for listening for individual section. But the last section, last mock test I have given, that and the feedback given by you that I was lacking in the written lecture and something in answers or questions that I prepared very well, and that I'll get back to soon.
That's right. So it's very important to know where you're missing out, because normally if you miss out in listening, we just keep on practicing listening. Very important. You do sectional and full mock tests and see from which part or which area you're losing points in. Narvik, reading, how to prepare for reading. A lot of students are not really getting the scores in reading. What did you do in reading? You have got the score in reading twice or thrice, I guess. What is important for reading?
The reading, the most important part is if you have to understand the context. Like, we can't rely on the repeating question every time in the exam, because it will be the waste of time and waste of the money. So I was lacking in reading as well, but after the feedback given by the Shaminder sir and you, that I it really helped me get the 79 ish, because when I start my journey with PTE, that I think that I never will get in reading. I will get in listening, writing, speaking, but I will never get score in reading. But practice and the understanding of contents in the paragraphs, that will be helping you.
That's right.
Yes, even though I have done many times practice on App Uni for 50, 60 question, all the questions. So that will help me a lot.
That's right, Namik. That's very, very important. You practice, but on top of that, don't just focus on cramming things. If you just cram, fill in the blanks in reading or reorders in reading and expect you'll get the same in the exam, things can be difficult. You need to make sure you understand the context. Attend grammar sessions. Grammar sessions are very, very important. And on top of that, make sure you take regular mock tests. That will help you boost your reading score as well. If he has gone from 60 to 90s, you can do it as well. But you need to make sure you have the right guidance, right strategies, and right feedback. Any final piece of advice for students out there, Namik, who are preparing for the exam, who can't really come to a physical classes in Sydney? Any advice for them, please?
Basically, I was a student of Brisbane, online student. So I never think that I will get the score, but I started the journey with online classes with Language Academy. It really helped me. Just do practice every day with the classes online, and do practice as much as you can, because, and never ever give up with the PT, because one day you will gonna get the score for this kind of exam.
That's right. So it's kind of a doable exam, right? But it requires hard work and practice. Doesn't matter where you're sitting on, doesn't matter if you're sitting on 50, 60, wherever you're sitting, you need to make sure you put your 120%, you give your 120%, you will get the score, but you need to make sure you're consistent. I remember he used to practice, even 12 hours a day. He used to message me midnight that, yes, I've got this thing wrong. What are the things I need to work on? And that is what has paid off. I really believe that. You know, it's not like that I just told you a strategy and you just went and, got up and went for the exam and got the score. It's more about implementing the strategies, getting the feedback, practicing, having conversation with your tutors, taking the feedback, seeing what they are, you know, really perceiving it as what they think, what you're doing, what are the things you need to work on, improving all your weaknesses, taking the mock test and then going for the exam. It requires practice, hard work, perseverance and consistency. And if you do so, you're going to get ADH as well. Thank you for joining in, Amik. All the very best for your Nati now. You're going to do that thank as well, so and sir. You're going to make another video then. Huh?
Yes, thank you. Yeah, sure. All the best. One thing I would like to tell the Language Academy that I was lacking in the pronunciation for a particular speaking section, but the new speaking strategy was like awesome. It was really, really helped me to get this 79 each in speaking, because I will never ever get the score in speaking if I will speak all the things. But yes, the new speaking strategy really helped me. Yes.
That's
thank
fair,
you so much
fair.
For that.
Thanks for that, Namik. A pleasure. Very well done. Make sure you follow all the strategy, guys. All the strategies are very, very important. And it's not just about following the strategy. It's more about following them in a proper manner. It's not about knowing a strategy. It's more about implementing the strategy properly. And if you do so, you're going to get the score like he has got, like a lot of other students do get. Thank you, Namik. Once again, all the very best.
Thank you so much.
I'll see you soon. Thanks, guys. That's it from this video. We'll be back with another success story. Till then, make sure you keep on practicing. Take a number of mock tests. Have the right guidance, right direction, and right feedback. Learn from Language Academy.